This is the real celebration of Bhagwan Nithyananda. The children and animals all together, one place. No inhibitions, no prohibitions. All are together here. The real tattva of Nithyananda can be experienced here at Jeeva Samadhi of Shaligram Swami. Celebration here, celebration. I am right now near Ganeshpuri, and this is a place, very divine place. This is on the way to Mandagni Mountain, a holy hill where ancient rishis did their tapas and did a lot of havans and all that. It's mentioned even in the Puranas and in the Navanath Granthas also. This place is there. This place is a place of Lord Gorakshanath ji and Lord Machendranath ji. So this place, this is in between Ganeshpuri and some villages, and towards Mandagni Mountain. It's still far, but this stream which is there, here lived a great Siddha named Shankar Swami. Shankar Swami was a direct disciple of Bhagwan Nithyananda, and Bhagwan Nithyananda sent him to this jungle here. So he used to live here in complete isolation. Nobody knows much about him. He lived completely in isolation, no publicity, no public interaction of any way. And he used to live in those days alone here and do his tapas here alone. That time it was a very dense jungle. Now it's still open a bit. So we had come here 12 years back, and we are coming after 12 years with Nitin Bhai. He brought us here, and today again we found him, and we were happy to come here. So unfortunately, there was a yogi for 40 years. He was serving this Jeeva Samadhi. Okay, Shankar Swami took his Jeeva Samadhi in this place. The Samadhi is here. I'll show you that place. And for his seva, 40 years, a yogi from somewhere, Andhra Pradesh, he came here, and 40 years he lived alone in this jungle. So last time when we came, it's there, 12 years back in my channel, it's there, that video. We met him and he made black tea for us, and very kind and very humble person. Such a great tapasvi, but humble. So I'm just climbing up from the stream. So this stream is where Shankar Swami bathed, and he drank water and all that. So, and this is a Parshuram Kshetra. This is known as a Bal Parshuram Kshetra. It's said and believed that Lord Parshuram, in his childhood, he spent his days here. So that's why it's called Bal Parshuram Kshetra. So we were there in the temple of Parshuram ji. Bal Parshuram Swarup is there, his vigra is there. And you can see this is the small cottage in which the Jeeva Samadhi of Shankar Swami is there. So I'll just take you there. Last time we are missing that yogi. He helped us do sadhana here, and he gave us all the information of this place. So this is, he is looking after this place now, right now. So this is the front part. We came from here. We came from the villages, and it proceeds towards Mandagni. That's Mandagni, that side. The mountain. So this is that. So it's completely jungle here and nobody here. So he used to stay alone here. And Shankar Swami just used to eat a little dal. That was his only food. And all the time he used to wander around in this jungle. Finally, before taking his samadhi. So his samadhi is here. I'll take you in.
अंबाडी
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 आता पानाची भाजी बनवतात.
अच्छा खाऊ शकता असं?
हा खाऊ शकते.
पान खायचं काय सर?
नाही होते
आंबट आंबट हे सुकवून जंगलामध्ये राहणारे जे लोक आहेत
अरे वा
भाजीमध्ये टाकतात.
खरं
त्यांना टोमॅटो भेटत नाही जागी हे भाजीमध्ये आंबट वस्तू म्हणून अंबाडी किंवा चिंच अशी वस्तू टाकतात.
वा